pranayama. We all breathe, but bringing the awareness into the breathing is called as pranayama. Breathing with awareness is called as pranayama. When we are happy, we inhale deeper when you are happy. And we inhale some good news. I see that one. I inhale. I want to absorb more energy into my body. Or if I want to smell a flower, it's so beautiful. I want to smell. I inhale. I want to take the positive, more and more positive into the body. It's coincides with inhale. And exhalation, when we hear a depressing news, is it? Our spine collapses and we crunch our lungs, is it? And a depressed person, if you look at, there is whole body is crumbled up. The way in which he or she walks, the shoulders becomes droopy and head down, and it's a exhalation. When you are happy and you walk like a victorious person, chest, your shoulders have moved back, you walk like a victorious person. When you are happy, inhale. When you are exhale, it's sad, you exhale. You exhale the energy, and that's inhalation and exhalation. And yesterday, we touched upon an interesting concept in Bhagavad Gita, in the second chapter. Ascharyavat pasyati kaschidenam ascharyavadat ena kaschit ascharyavat anyashunoti shrutva pyenam vedana chaiva kaschit. The ascharya, wonder. It's a wonder. The wonder, it is described as the most supreme Lord is wonder, described as most wonderful. When you come across a meet such an experience within in meditation, which you never heard, something you experienced. No books have told that one, no teacher has mentioned. Something marvelous you experience within. Ascharyavat pashyati kaschidenam. Ascharyavat vadati tataiva chanyaha. Ascharyavat shrunopi chanya shrunoti chainam. Shrutvapyenam vedana chaiva kaschit. When you hear, experience that wonder, that which you never experienced, you are neither inhaling nor exhaling, breathing stops. That you are wonder struck to look at the most wonderful thing. You are neither inhaling nor exhaling. You experience that moment. Moment in your life, in the scripture talks about that most wonderful when you experience. You experience it is not a deliberate kumbhaka. Automatically, that either that kumbhaka retention happens, whether out or in, your breathing completely stops. That experience, that moment, in fact, it is called as pranayama. In fact, you are neither inhaling nor exhaling. That moment you experience prana apana gati rudva pranayama parayanaha. Rudva means stopping. You are neither inhaling nor exhaling. That moment you experience, that is, Sri Krishna says, the knowers of this one tells this one as a pranayama. You are wonderstruck. You experience that moment in your life, and when you experience that one, that most wonderful, which you never heard, when you experience that one, it is, you are neither inhaling nor exhaling. That moment, it is called as pranayama. What happens when you experience that one? In Patanjali, he talks about Tata Kshiyate Prakasha Avaranam. And in Patanjali, he talks about when you experience that moment, whatever covering is there, covering the light, inner light, it melts down. You start seeing things clearly. Whatever the mask, that light is there, inner light, it is covered by various layers. When you experience that moment, that covering kshiyate, it melts down and the light from within shines out. So what we thought earlier, pranayama is just holding the one nose and other nose, and now the pranayama takes us to the another level. This pranayama, that pranayama, you are neither inhaling and exhaling. What is the benefit of that one? And the light, the covering, the light which is being covered by various layers, they get melted down. You experience the light within, and light from within shines out. You start leading an illumined life. You start leading a brilliant life. This life is not to be led in a dull way, ordinary way, and we are meant to lead a life in a brilliant way, in a brilliant, magnanimous way, glorious way. How it is possible? In the Bhagavad Gita it talks about, Yoga Shastras talk about, that remove the covering, which is covering the inner light. And that happens when you see the most wonderful. Ascharyavat kaschiti paschidenam. That, and in the people, they say, talk about that one as a wonder. They see that one as a wonder. They talk that one as a wonder. They hear about that one as a wonder. Even after hearing from thousands of people, that wonder remains still a wonder. For the most illumined person, God is still a wonder. Most illumined person, God still remains a wonder. And they are not satisfied what they have experienced. They want to dive deep into that wonderful nature. Whatever, however wonderful is the world, I go out, after going 2 times, 3 times, I feel bored. Let us go to another place. But one who has experienced that one, there is no boredom. I want to experience that one again. I am not satisfied. I want to experience. For those, even most illumined people, he is still a wonder and most wonderful. They are not satisfied with what they are seeing. They want to immerse themselves into that one. That is the pranayama leading us to the samadhi. The samadhi in the pranayama, when you see that one, it takes you. And when you have experienced the most wonderful, what is there to talk about? The things outside. And you experience that one. Left